sun was shining on the sea, shining with all his might. He did his very best to make the billows smooth and bright. This was odd because it was the middle of the night. Moon was shining sulkily, 'cause she had thought the sun got no business to be there after the day was done. Very rude of him, she said, to come and spoil the fun. Sea was wet as wet could be, sands were dry as dry. Could not see a cloud because no cloud was in the sky. No birds were flying overhead, and the carpenter were walking close at hand. They wept like anything to see such quantities of sand. If this were only cleared away, they said it would be grand. If seven maids with seven ropes swept it for half a year, suppose the walrus said that they could get it clear. I doubt it, said the carpenter, and shed a bitter tear. Oysters, come and walk with us, walrus did beseech. Pleasant walk, a pleasant. Cannot do with more than four to give a hand to each. The eldest oyster looked at him, but never a word he said. The eldest oyster winked his eye and shook his heavy head, meaning to say he did not choose to leave the oyster. Young oysters hurried up, eager for the tree. Coats were brushed, their faces washed, their shoes were clean and neat. This was odd because, you know, they hadn't any feet. Four other oysters followed them, and yet another four. They came at last, and more and more and more, all hopping through the frothy waves and scrambling to the shore. Walrus and the carpenter walked on a mile or so. Then they rested on a rock conveniently low. And all the oysters stood and waited in a row. Time has come, the walrus said, to talk of many things, of shoes and ships and sealing wax, cabbages and kings, why the sea is boiling hot, whether have wings. But wait a bit, the oysters cried, before we have our chat. Some of us are out of breath, and all of us are fat. No hurry, said the carpenter, they thanked him much for that. Loaf of bread, the pepper and vinegar besides a oysters cried, turning a little blue. After such kindness, that would be a dismal thing to do. Night is fine, the walrus said, do you admire the view? It was so kind of you to come, and you are very nice. Carpenter said nothing, but cut us another slice. I wish you were not quite so deaf, I've had to ask you twice. It seems a shame, the walrus said, to play them such a trick. After we've brought them out so far and made them trot so quick, Carpenter said nothing but the butter's spread too thin. Wait for you, the walrus. With sobs and tears he sorted out those of the largest size, holding his pocket handkerchief for his streaming eyes. Oh, oyster, said the carpenter, you had a pleasant run. Shall we be trotting home? And this was scarcely odd, because